All right, so today we are doing a strength and abdominal workout. So we're going to work on the core. What I would like you to get is some weights. I'm going to use just some tins today. So I've got, I like to mix it up a bit. So we've got some baked beans and some mango, tinned mango. So grab your tins of beans, or if you've got weights, obviously use your dumbbells, use your weights if you've got some. You might want a mat. I've got a mat here. I'm going to move it out of the way actually for now. So you might want a mat to do your floor work on. We are going to be standing and we're going to be lying down to do some abdominals as well today, okay? So we're going to get warmed up. It's so cold today. The weather's really took a change, hasn't it? So it's much cooler today. So I'm just checking to see if anybody's joining us live at all. I think lots of you are going to be doing this later on, which is absolutely fine. Okay, so let's get warmed up and start marching through. Make sure, if like me, you've got a rug, that you either are very aware of where the edges are, so that you don't trip or anything like that, or you can roll it up and move it out of the way, okay? Abs are nice and tight. Be aware if you've got lights above your head and things like that as well. So let's get warmed up. So we don't want to be putting the heating on, do we? So this is a really good way to get warmed up. I might take the jumper off in a little bit, but for now it's staying on, that's for sure. Let's get marching, moving those arms, driving the elbows back and forward. That's it. Good, good, good. And then from here, I want you to set the feet apart a little bit, soften the knees, reaching forward, driving the elbows back. So we're reaching forward and driving those elbows back. Good, good, good. Imagine you're pulling a rope. You feel that squeeze in between the shoulder blades. Is it lovely? Good, good, good. Last couple here. Want to really warm up the back and the chest. And then from here, just reach across. A little bend in the knees. That's it. Because we're going to be using the weights, I want to make sure all of the muscles, the joints are warmed up. So I'm softening the knees, then I'm reaching up over the head. Nice stretch there. Good, good, good. Last couple here. Well done. I want you to take your chin down towards your chest and then back, looking up towards the ceiling, taking it down and then up towards the ceiling and then down. Towards the ceiling again, then looking forward, I want you to just look over one shoulder and then over the other one. Good, good, good. Lovely. And then from here, I'm going to turn to the side, drop the chin towards the chest, let the shoulders just round forward, and then I want you to hang, just slide all the way down as far as you can, and then all the way back up. When we get to the top, we roll the shoulders back and then we look up. And then let's repeat that. So chin down towards the chest, round the shoulders, rolling down one vertebrae at a time, all the way down, all the way back up. Lovely, excellent. Let's go down into some squats. So the toes are facing forward, the feet are just underneath the hips there, and we're dropping the bum back and down. So from the side, we're bending those knees a lot, if we can. Pushing that bum back and down. As we rise up, if I lift the jumper, you can see I'm just squeezing the bum and I'm tilting the pelvis slightly at the top. That's it. So we get the bum squeeze, and that's what's going to really help to warm up those glutes. That's it. Last couple here, everyone. Let's do one more, one more. Perfect. We're going in for a deadlift. So I want a nice flat back. So no rounding through the back, okay? Think about a nice flat back. Hands down your thighs. So before we really rounded the back, now I want you to keep your back nice and flat. I want you to push your bum towards the back of the room. And then just take the hands down until your back is roughly parallel with the floor and then coming back up. So what I don't want is for your hands to go anywhere further than mid-shin. Because if we go further down, we start rounding through the back. Can you see? So we want to stop when the back is still flat and it's parallel to the floor. So with this, you should be feeling a nice stretch in the hamstrings down the back of the legs. Lovely, coming back up. Let's do one more there. Working through the back, through the glutes, and through the hamstrings. Let's rise up onto the toes. So we're coming up onto the toes and then back down, warming up through the calves. Good, good, good. So we're going to do some standing work and we're going to do some floor work today as well, okay? That's it. Keep that going, keep that going. Excellent. I think Steph's watching. Hi, Steph. That's it. Keep going, keep going. Up on those toes. Last couple. Excellent. And then just taking those arms out, we're going to do a few little shoulder rolls. So we're just taking those arms, circle motions, just little circles. I'm going backwards. Doesn't matter which direction you go because we're going to go in both directions. I want you to change direction now. That's it. Lovely. Good, good, good. And then finally, to finish your warm up, let's just loosen off through that back. Little swings. That's it. Make sure you're picking one heel up off the floor, because if your feet stay planted, you could pull your knees or pull the ankles. Make sure that you're coming up. Oh, can you hear my dog barking? That's the postman. The joys of waking from home. That's it. She will stop barking in a minute if you can hear her. Last couple. That's it. Lovely. Excellent. Well done. We're going to start our main workout now. So grab your tins of beans, all your dumbbells, whatever you're using for your weights. We're going to start with a front raise and a lateral raise. So we're going to take the weights here. We're going to lift them in line with the shoulders and then out to the side, okay? So first of all, get your posture correct. So shoulders back, pull those shoulders down the spine, and then from there, let's go. We take the weights forward in line with the shoulders and then out to the side in line with the shoulders. Forward in line with the shoulders, and then out to the side in line with the shoulders. I want you to just go at your own pace, whatever feels right for you. It all depends on how heavy the weights are that you're holding. I don't want you to go any higher with the shoulders, so just make sure that you're not lifting above those shoulders. That's it. Good, good, good. So front raise and then a lateral raise. Abs are nice and tight. When you're standing here, make sure you've got those abs really nice and tight. I know that I've got a baggy jumper on today, but it's just a bit chilly. But I have got the abs nice and tight. I've got the knees slightly soft, so I haven't got the legs locked out completely. Last couple here. One more. And then from here, we're going into your squats. So let's go straight down into those squats. So you're looking forward in your squat. I want you to keep your chest lifted slightly as that bum goes down. What we don't want in a squat is to be dropping the head. If we drop the head, the bum won't go down as low. That's it, the bum lifts up when we drop the chest and the head. So we want, I'm going to face you. So we want that chest lifted, looking forward. So you're looking at the screen, drop that bum down. Again, I'm squeezing my bottom as I rise up. Squeezing the bum cheeks. That's it. Lovely. You might notice as soon as you come on to using the lower body, those bigger muscles, that you get a little bit, you can hear in my voice, that you start getting a little bit out of breath. Because they're bigger muscles, they demand more oxygen when we use them. Wait with your breath. Breathe out on the way up. Five, four, three, two, one more. Lovely, well done, well done. We're going into punches now, so we're gonna bring those weights up in front, take those feet just underneath the hips, and we start punching forward. That's it, lovely. Punches forward. Good, good, good. That's it, lovely. If you wanted to, you could add a little march to this. If you want your to get your breathing back down to normal, then just keep those feet still. That's totally up to you. I might do a little bit of each. That's it. Good, good, good. From the side, I'm extending the arms. Trying to keep those arms in line with the chest. I'm not letting them drop as I punch, okay? That's it. Keep going. You can march or not. That's totally up to you. Keep going. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, and one. Okay, I'm just going to move behind this lamp because we're going to reach above our head. With the weights in the hands, we're going to go back to that squat. Take your feet a little bit wider and turn the toes out just a touch. We're going to take the weights down here, squat down, looking forward, and then press up above the head. Okay, let's go. So we're trying to get those weights to the floor if possible, but your range of motion might be here, and that's fine. Okay, you go with what you can do, and as the weeks go on, you'll get fitter, you'll become more flexible, be stronger. That's it. And lots of things determine how low we can get with squats and things. That could be knee problems, back problems, hip problems. That's it. Because the wider the legs are, the more we open up those hips, the easier it is to get down towards the floor. But if you've got any hip mobility issues, then that means it's a little bit more difficult. So from the side, I am bending the knees to get down towards the floor. I'm not leaning from the back, okay? We are squatting and pressing. That's it. Let's keep going with these. That's it, lovely. 10, 9, 8, 7. I feel like this jumper's gonna come off soon. I'm getting warmer. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 more here. Lovely. Let me just check my notes to see what's next. All right, we're going in for a high knee lift, but we're going to try and hold those arms out. So we're going to do 10 high knees with the arms held out. Then we're going to give the shoulders a little break, okay? Arms out, high knees here, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give those arms a little break, shake them out. We're ready to go again. Let's go. 10, 9, lift those knees as high as you can. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms down. We're going two more times for this. Are we ready? Arms up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Higher. 3, 2, 1. Arms down. One more time. Shake them out. Little breather. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done. Really good, everybody. Really good. All right, next on my list, have you got upright rows? So set the feet just about hip distance apart. Again, I'm always softening the knees, okay? So I'm never locking the knees out. So soften those knees. Shoulders pull them back, and then we drive the elbows up and down. Lift those elbows up and down. I want you to keep going, keep going. I'm just gonna take this jumper off now. It's time. Hopefully you're getting a bit warmer as well. Keep those elbows lifting up and down. Oh, see, such a good way to warm the body up, isn't it? Doing your exercises. I was so cold earlier, but I'm not giving in and putting the heating on, that's for sure. Drive those elbows up. That's it, and then back down. Lovely, keep this going. My top's gone all static off since I took my jumper off. That's it, keep going. 10, down, 9, 8, 7, 6, keep going, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 more. Lovely, we've got lunges coming up. So I'm gonna turn to the side. We're gonna take one leg back and we're gonna keep that leg back, okay? The heel is lifted. And then we're gonna drop this back knee down towards the floor. We'll keep the shoulders back and the chest lifted. I don't want you to lean forward, okay? 10 on one leg, 10 on the other. Are we ready? Let's go. 10, lift, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Keep going. 4, 3, two, and one. Well done. And again, your range of motion, your range of movement is totally up to you. You might go right down the floor. You might not be anywhere near the floor, and it doesn't matter. It's your workout, nobody else's. Shoulders back, chest lifted. Ooh, wobble. Let's go. One, two, three. This is my wobbly side. Four, and again, five, six, seven. Remember, we're not leaning forward like this. I've lost count. Nine. Oh no, let's do two more. Completely lost count because I was talking. Last one, well done. Good work, everybody. Let's see what's next. Okay, we've got deadlifts. So this time we keep the legs almost straight. We're gonna have a slight bend in the knees. The back is nice and straight. We did these in the warm up. So we push the bum back, stop when the back is parallel with the ground. Don't go so far that you're rounding through the back, okay? So this would be my lowest point. And then back up. Are we ready? Let's go. Take it down and up. So a squat, which we did earlier, is where we bend the knees a lot and we drop the bum down towards the floor. Your deadlift, you're pushing your bum towards the back of the room. Just a tiny little bend in the knees, okay? So we want to work the bottom and the lower back, and you'll get a little workout through the hamstrings as well here. That's it. Good, good, good. In the warm-up, we did these, but with completely straight legs. This time, we're adding a little bit of a bend into them. That's it. Good, good. Keep the weights close to your legs. So you don't want your weights hanging over here somewhere. I want them close to the body. It's always safer keeping those weights closer. That's it. Let's go five. Four, I'm squeezing the bum as I rise up. Three, and again. Two, one more. Lovely, well done. We've got bicep curls next, okay? So we're gonna go in for hammer position, so that's the palms turned inwards. We're doing a single, and then two doubles. Okay, let's go. Single, single, double, double, and again. Single, single, double, double. At your own pace. I'm going to stop saying single, single, double, double because I want you to just go at your own pace and I don't want to confuse you, okay? You might be doing it slightly slower or slightly faster than me. But you want one on each arm and then both arms working twice. That's it. Lovely. In your hammer curl here, you'll notice that my upper arms are not moving. So by that, I mean my elbows are not coming here. So when I'm curling, I'm not doing this. Okay, I want those upper arms stuck to your sides so that the upper arms are not moving. Lovely. Let's get a few more of these in. Three more full ones. So single, single, double, double, three more times. Good, good, good. That's it. Lovely, and again. I don't know if I've still got one more. What is wrong with my counting today? Why can I not? Sometimes I can talk and I know exactly where I am with my counting. Well done, today I feel like I'm losing it. Okay, so we're gonna take the arms above the head. If using the weights feels too much for this one, you can do it without the weights, you can put the weights down. So we're gonna take the weights above the head. And again, we're doing a single, single, double, double. So it's going to be single, single, and then double pull down and press. Join in. Let's go. Single, single, double, double. And again, single, single, double, double. Keep going. Single, single, double. Double, keep going. Go at your own pace. So again, just if this feels too much with weights in your hands, you can put those weights down and just reach with the hands. Let's do three more. Single, single, two doubles. And again, single, single, two two doubles. And again, last time, single, single, double. Lovely, finish strong, bring it in. Let me see what's next. Okay, we're going into a reverse alternating lunge. So let me turn to the side for this one for you. So again, when we lunge back, I don't want your body to lean forward if possible. Pull the shoulders back, keep the chest lifted. We're gonna do a four count lunge. So we go one, two, three, four, change leg. One, two, three, four, join in, back, down, up, no faster than this if you can help it, back, knee towards the floor, up and in. Remember, your lunge might just be a tiny bend in the knee. That's absolutely fine. Back, take it down, bring it up and in. What we don't want here is the leaning forward, okay? Try and keep your shoulders above the hips. That's it. And in. Back. Down. Up. And in. Back. Down. Up. I'm going to turn towards you. And in. Back. Down. Up. And in. Back. Down. Wobble up. And in. Does everybody else have one side that they're really wobbly on? Up and in. One more. Out. Down. Up and in. Well done, well done, well done. Okay, we're doing standing chest presses. So I think we might have done some of these last week. Oh no, last week we did walking workout, didn't we? We've done these recently. So elbows are out and I want the weights in line with your chest. So I don't want them up here or too low. Get them in line with your chest. And then from here, we press forward and pull back. Remember, we did these in the warm-up without any weight. Join in. Good, good, good. Press and pull. You won't want anything too heavy for this movement because when you push those weights forward, it's actually quite challenging. Press and pull. I want you to feel that squeeze in the shoulder blades here as you pull those elbows back. Press and pull. Press and pull. Press and pull. Press and pull. Lovely. 10 and in. 9. In. 8. Keep this going. 7. And again. 6. 5. Doing good. Don't rush these. 4. And again. 3. Last couple, everyone. 2. And 1. Well done. I want you to set yourself up on the floor and have a sip of water at this point. And then I'm just might need to angle my cameras down a little bit, but let's have a little look first. Use this as a little break. Let's see. Yeah, right, I'm just going to move. Give me 1 second, I need to move these cameras around a little bit. Okay, so let's pop you on a cushion on the floor here. Good, good, good. I think this one's all right. Okay, so from here, we're gonna go into some bridges. So, I'm just gonna move my notes. All right, so tins by your side because we will be using those and I want you to lie on your back. So we're gonna, I'll give you two options here, okay? So you can either have the tins by your side. I'm not worried if you can't see my face in the screen. It's more important that you see my lower body here. So I want the feet quite close to your bum and then we're gonna squeeze your bottom, rise up and then bring the bum back down towards the floor. I also want the lower back to touch the ground as well, okay? So if you want to make this a little bit harder, you can pop the tins on the hips there, okay? Are we ready? And let's go. So squeezing the bum and then back down. So I've just got my hands on the tins to keep them balanced so that they don't fall, but I'm not holding them so that I'm not taking any weight off them. Okay, so obviously you could use heavier weights if you've got them and want to use them. That's it. And as I come down, I'm making sure that I tilt the pelvis back slightly and pushing the lower back. My lower back is coming in contact with the floor. Lovely. Good, good, good. And again, I don't want these too fast, really. That's it. Squeezing the bum, lowering back down. And again, squeeze and lower. Let's do five more. All the way up, just as high as you can. That's it. Four. Back down. Doing a good job, everyone. Three. Back down. Two. One more here. Lovely. Well done. We're going in for a lying. We did a standing chest press before. We're going to do a lying chest press now. So elbows are out so that the weights, again, are in line with your chest. Your arms are not up here. You want the weights in line with your chest. Push that lower back down into the ground and then press the weights above the chest. Let's go. So those weights are meeting above the chest. Okay. So what I don't want is the weights to end up coming over your head like this. We want the weights in line with the chest. It's a chest press. Good, good, good. Keep this going. Few here. Well done, everyone. Let's do 10 more. That's it, lovely. And again. Five more from here. Five, four, three, two. Hold this one at the top. Turn the palms inwards towards each other and then elbows close to your sides. Now we press up and down. So now rather than having the elbows out wide, I've got the elbows tucked in by the ribs. So as I come up and down with those arms, my upper arms are scraping past the ribs. Okay, they're touching the outsides of those ribs. This is a tricep press. Well done. I'm just gonna roll down a teeny bit. Keep going, everyone. And all the time here, I've got that lower back pushed into the floor. And by that, I mean, I'm not arching. I don't have the ribs pushed up towards the ceiling. That's it. So there's no gap between my lower back and the floor. Well done, last couple. And then we take those arms up, hold it here. And then I want you to bend at the elbows. Let those tins just roll by the ears and then back up. Okay, this is called a skull crusher. So your arms are coming just head, your arms are just about head width apart. You can just get those weights past the sides of the head, taking the weights down towards the floor. What we're looking for in this movement is hardly any movement in the shoulder itself. So by that, I mean, you're not moving the shoulders and the upper arms. Everything's pretty still, except that elbow joint, okay? We're just moving from the elbow joint. We're not moving from the shoulders as well. That's it, keep going. It is a tough one. That's it, a bit of concentration needed. Last one, then take those weights up above the chest again, and then we open the arms nice and wide. Hopefully you're still with us, you're still doing this. Arms nice and wide. Good, good, good. So again, we've got a little bend in the elbows. I haven't got the arms locked out completely. And then again, we're working on the chest here. We're moving on to abs very soon. We've got another set of bridges to do. That's it. Your bridges are a great core movement. So you've got your core muscles, you've got your glutes, you've got your hamstrings, your lower back working really hard. Five and close. Four and close. Three, almost there. Two, one more, everybody. This time for your bridges, I want you to carefully place those weights down by your side. take the hands by your side. We're going to go up, we're going to pulse the bum, squeeze the bum as we lift up for three pulses and then all the way back down. So it's going to look like this. We're going to squeeze, squeeze, squeeze and back down. Let's go, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. So we're kind of just dropping that bum an inch or so. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze and down. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze and down. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. That's it. You'll be feeling this in your bum tomorrow. That's it. And again, lift, lift, lift. Five more. Let's go. Lift, lift, lift. That's one. Lift, squeeze, squeeze. That's two. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. That's three. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. That's four. Squeeze, last time, squeeze, squeeze. That's five. Well done. Bring those knees in towards the chest and just have a little rock side to side. We're going to go into some abdominal movements. We're going to start with some basic crunches here. So again, feet on the floor. I'm going to move slightly back. Take the hands either across your chest or just beside the head here, and we're going to go in for a little basic crunch. Are we ready? Let's go now. Crunch and down. So as I lift up and down, I might just put my arms here so that you can see, I can sort of look towards you when I'm talking. So I'm taking the head and the shoulders and just a little bit of the upper back off the floor. As I crunch up, I'm rounding the spine, I'm pushing the lower back into the ground, and I'm tucking the chin slightly, but it's not, you do want a gap between your chin and your chest, but I am rounding the neck and the back slightly. That's it. And as I come down, don't let the back arch as you come down. I want you to keep pushing that lower back in to the floor. Let's do a couple more. It two and one. Well done. We're going to extend one leg, so let me move a little bit. We're extending one leg and we're going to go in for opposite elbow to knee and then back down. So crunch in and then out, crunching in and out. So I've got the right knee coming in, so my right elbow and shoulder stay on the floor. It's the left elbow and shoulder that are lifting off the floor and crunching across the body. That's it. Good, good, good. Let's do three and again, two and again, one. And then we switch side. So over to the opposite side, let's go. So now that I've got the left leg moving, I've got the left shoulder and arm on the floor, and it's the right elbow that is pushing across towards that left knee. Keep going. Four, three, two, one more. Lovely. Well done. Really good. So from here, right hand, we're going to take the head and the shoulders off the floor, and the right hand is going to keep crunching down towards that right foot, okay? So I'm going right and then just back to the center. I'm not going over to the left side, okay? So we lift up to the center here, right, center, right, center. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Head down to give your neck a little bit of a rest, and then we do 10 on the left, okay? Are we ready? Crunch up, tuck the chin slightly to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Head down, give your neck a little bit of a rest. This time we go side to side, right to left, okay? So get ready. Head off the floor. Are you ready? Let's go. Right, left. Right, left. That's two. Right, left. That's three. Right, left, that's four, right, left, right, left. This is seven, and again, eight, and again, nine. One more time. Well done, and down. You should be feeling these in your abs. I can absolutely feel these. So let's have a stretch out at this point. Stretch out, let the back come off the floor slightly, open up those ribs towards the ceiling. Have a good stretch for those abdominals. Oh, like a good morning stretch. And then coming back in, we're gonna go in for some reverse crunches, okay? So at this point, I'm gonna have the hands either by the side or under the bum. I prefer them just under the bum slightly. I feel like my back needs that support. So we're gonna bring the knees in towards the chest and then lightly tap the heels to the floor. So when you feel ready, you can start this. So with this one, I don't want you to roll all the way back like this, okay? It's more controlled than that. We're bringing the knees in towards the chest and the bum and just a small amount of the lower back the bum and a small amount of the lower back comes off the floor. When we take the heels down towards the ground, I want you to push your lower back into the ground because what wants to happen is your back wants to arch like this. And I don't want that to happen. I want you to push that lower back down. So your abs have to work really hard here. We're gonna go for 10 more here, everyone. 10, push that lower back down. 9, working hard here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, how we doing? 3, 2, 1 more. Lovely, well done. I want you to keep those knees bent if you can. And just let the knees flop over to one side, okay? From here, so I've got my knees flopped over to the left, okay? I'm gonna take the hands behind the head. I'm gonna do a crunch, but as I crunch, I'm gonna reach down towards the heel, okay? So the right hand will come off the head and reach down towards the foot. So I've got my knees to the left. My right hand is gonna reach towards that foot and then back down. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, so the head and shoulders are coming off the floor. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 more, 2, and 1. Lovely. And don't worry if you can't actually reach the heel. You're just heading in that direction. So now reset and take the knees over. So I've got the knees to the right now. Okay, and then we're going to crunch. Let's go. So I'm reaching towards the left side. The left arm is reaching towards the heels. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How are we doing? And 10. Well done, well done. We're almost there, everybody. You're doing really well. We're going to take the legs into the air. So you can either have the knees bent, but if possible, straighten those legs, okay? We're going to take the arms nice and wide. And then we're reaching for the toes. So I want you to settle that lower back down into the ground. Arms nice and wide, everyone. And then we crunch up, reach for the toes, and then back down. So again, how high you reach, it's up to you. It doesn't matter how high you can reach. That's it. You just, as long as you're reaching as high as you feel like you can, that's what's important. And again, you could have the knees like this if it feels too much to keep those legs in the air, or you could even do the movement with the feet on the floor. But you know, be honest with yourself what you're able to do, because we always want to push ourselves a little bit, but without, you know, we need to make the workout as hard as we can, but without injuring ourselves in any way. Should we do 5 more? 5, 4, 3, One more. Lovely, everybody. Feet down. We're going to stretch out. I want you to take your arms and your knees up towards the ceiling. And then we'll take the knees to one side and your arms and your head to the opposite side, if possible. And just relax. Take a moment there. And then over towards the other side. Knees to one side, arms and head to the other. Lovely. And then take the hands onto the knees and just circle those knees. Bring them towards you and then away from you. So you're rolling on that lower back a little bit. A nice little massage for that lower back. Change direction. That's it. Good, good, good. Let's go one more. Well done. Okay, sit yourselves up. I'm going to come up. We're going to take the hands behind the back. Fingertips facing the bottom. Walk the hands inwards towards each other. And then lengthen the arms and push the chest up towards the, on a diagonal, up towards the, looking towards the Cobra. Pushing my chest up towards there. That's it. Good, good, good. And then sitting up nice and tall, clasp your fingers. Keep your back nice and straight. And I want you to push those shoulders forward. Drop the chin down. And then we're going to take the hands onto the shins and we can just round the back, tuck the chin into your chest. Lovely. Excellent. And then from here, let's lengthen out those legs. So we're going to reach forward towards the toes. And, you know, everybody's different here. This is about my limit today. Some days I can get to the toes, some days I can't. So it really just depends on how your body's feeling that day. Come out of that stretch, just have a second, and then we go back into it and you should get a little bit further. Yep, I can just about get to those toes now. Good, good, good. Well done. Okay, make sure that you hydrate now, so that I want you to have a drink of water, hydrate yourself. Have a lovely healthy lunch, so carbohydrates, proteins in there, some healthy fats, and have a lovely day. And I really appreciate you all joining me today. Well done.